Hey, I'm Lars from the Dog Spotters, and today I've got the opportunity to interview Fatima Dazi. She's a filmmaker from Ghana. Fatima, I'm glad to have you with us today.
Nice to meet you too.
So, 2 days ago was the premiere of your film Fatty's Choice. It's a documentary about a Ghanaian woman who decided she would return to Ghana after fleeing to Italy. And the film also shows the challenges that she was facing when returning back home. How did you feel watching the premiere of your film at the cinema? And how do you feel today?
Yeah, so I was very excited to watch it on a big screen because I've been working on this thing for the past 3 years. So to see it on a big screen was a very special day for me. And I'm glad that people received it well, yeah.
I'm glad to hear that. So can you tell us how you and Fatty first met and how the film came to life?
Yeah, so before Fatty came into the picture, I already had an idea of doing a film about returnees and how they are trying to reintegrate back into their local communities, regardless of like the criticisms that is associated in being a returnee. So I was having a conversation with one cousin of mine who also tried traveling to Italy, but he couldn't make it, but he was with Fatty. And then I was having this conversation with him, and then Fatty's name came up. And then I got fascinated by her story, and I decided to pursue it. So that's how come I got in touch with Fatty, through a cousin of mine, yeah.
All right, now I want to talk to you about the film for a bit. There's one scene that sort of stands out, because it's filmed vertically. I'm sure you know what scene I mean. So, were you present when this scene was shot?
Which scene, if you can tell me? Which scene are you talking about?
Well, the scene where Fatty goes to try to rescue her children.
So, you know, when she wanted to go to pick the kids, she didn't want us there because she was going in secret and didn't want any commotion. Okay, so I said, no, we are not going to take a whole crew, just a phone camera, you know. So we're just hiding somewhere. So we're just lucky to have a snippet of what we took yesterday. So we're just there waiting for her to be successful so that our film will end up being successful. Yeah.
So who recorded that footage?
Yeah, it was me actually.
Okay, right. In the film, there are lots of scenes where Fatty gets really harshly criticized by her surroundings, by her neighbors, by family members, for the choice that she made. Why did you decide to give those critical and judgmental voices this much space in the film?
Yeah, because I also want to let people understand this is what is happening. And she even goes through worse than what you saw on TV. You know, I have even tried as much as possible to tone it down a bit so that it doesn't become, you know, too much for the viewer.
Yeah.
You get it? So it is what it is. People who return face even much more critical assessment from neighbors. And as a documentary, I show it as what it is anyway.
Yeah. Another topic that the film touches is how getting to Europe and living in the Western world is something that is glorified in Ghana and that's sort of connected with prestige. From your point of view, what are the reasons for this?
Yeah, so I have two reasons. First of all is the media that people are exposed to, you know, because whatever is shown on TV from the Western perspective, everything is nice. You can have access to everything without, because people don't see an exchange of cash, unlike my community. If you go to a store, you are expected to exchange cash. But what is shown on TV, you see somebody going to the grocery store, purchase something, put it in the basket, comes home, you know, you don't see much, I don't know, the hustling, you don't see much hustling. So it is the perspective. And then secondly, people who have been here don't tell people back home the truth, you know, because they also want to feel that kind of, that status symbol. So it is, everything is fine, I'm enjoying my life, and you are suffering, it makes them feel good. And those who come to tell the truth and still not believe, because people say that, no, I have to also come, experience this, and make judge it for myself. You understand? So it's kind of, that's the dynamic of all the whole situation.
Mm. Do you think there's something that Europeans can do to help fix the situation?
That I don't know. But I think the change must come from us, and our government have to do better.
Yeah.
Because I don't think if people are comfortable where they are, they would actually travel. If I have to travel, then I just want to see the other side of the world, but not to come in, you know.
Thank you so much for your insight on this topic. I want to wrap up the interview by talking about Fatih again. Can you tell us a bit about what her life is like today and if the film changed her life at all?
Yeah, so now she's left the community that she is. Her first daughter has finally been, is in touch with the mother. She's now back home with her mother because she's now 17. And she's found ways to get in touch with the mom. They are living together now. She has all her five children. And, you know, finally, Fatih having the voice and making her story known, she herself, she's very happy about it. Initially, it was very difficult. She didn't want to cooperate because she didn't have the confidence that her story can make an impact, you know. But now, she's happy, and she hasn't seen the whole film though, but I've shown her some snippets when I was doing the editing and all that, and I think she's proud of what has come out of it.
Yeah, that's really great to hear. All right, Fatima, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoy the rest of your week. And if you guys want to catch more of what's going on at Doc Leipzig this year, feel free to check out our Doc Spotters YouTube channel, as well as our blog over at doc-spotters.de.